This is NDTV. And you're watching Classics.
Who do you expect to see with me in this beautiful setting but the one man who walks his talk? Mr. Jagmohan, Tourism and Culture Minister.
Thank you.
How marvelous to have you here.
Thank you.
And what a symbolic setting, because we cannot go too much in detail over what's happened. But whatever has happened has made one thing clear, that heritage matters in India.
Yes. Heritage matters very much in India now. Under the new policy which we have framed, we are giving a lot of importance to heritage. We believe that the heritage, if properly presented to the world, will enhance the image of India, will enable us to have rapid economic advancement, national integration, as well as cultural regeneration of India, which is very important.
But Jagmohanji, it's not just the policy, it is also public opinion.
Yes.
When was the last time you saw public opinion rally so strongly, irrespective of who's at fault, rally so strongly behind the cause of the Taj Mahal?
Yes.
You did not see this kind of unanimity even on an issue like Kargil.
I agree that this is a evidence of rising opinion in favor of preserving our heritage, enhancing it and strengthening it as also. And the drive that we have launched all over India is to create new hubs in which elements of culture, tourism, clean civic life are all synthesized. Actually, I have always believed that civilization, this tourism and culture, is a civilizational issue. How we present ourselves, how we behave, what are the value system in the society, how disciplined we are, how conscious we are of our surroundings.
But Jagmohanji, all this while, I am sure people said similar things, but this was never taken seriously, because heritage, culture were not popular issues. This time, the very fact that, if I can put it that way, the Prime Minister has chosen heritage and you over a very vital electoral alliance shows that this has now got elevated to a higher level in our thinking.
Yes, I entirely agree that now the heritage, preservation of our history and heritage is really getting top of the agenda. It is necessary also because this will improve the quality of life in India. Not only that, it will enable us to maintain our heritage. India's heritage really is superb, it's unique. And if you see the march of Indian civilization, the march of Indian culture, from the prehistoric times, start from, say, Dholivira, 7,000 years BC, and you see the intellectual heritage, the monumental heritage, you really see the very powerful mind of India, very profound mind of India, which produced these things. For example, if you go and see what Dholivira is, it is a great pattern of urban civilization. It means, right. From where did this thought emerge? How to plan it?
I think we'll come to where we have come from there, from setting up such marvelous urban civilization to ruining our cities. But let me stick to the larger issue on heritage. There was almost like a take it or leave it option given to the Prime Minister, that remove Mr. Jagmohan or the alliance goes. Did this worry you, scare you, amuse you, embarrass you, upset you?
No, I took it in a normal course. Well, I knew that what I was doing was my only duty, and there is nothing that I can say further about it, because the matter is under the court, sub judice it is.
Right. That is true, but at the same time, did you expect this kind of popular support for this?
No, not that much. I can say that it is very easy to become wise after the events, but right. In the earlier stage, I didn't think that so much support will be forthcoming for this. I merely pointed out what was happening.
But Jagmohanji, Taj Mahal is only one symbol. In fact, it's the biggest symbol of India's heritage. It's the one spot that people come to see, and it's the one spot that, in a way, people identify India with. But we have so much other heritage, which is in a mess. I've been to Mahabalipuram, the place stinks. Hampi, I believe, I have not been there, but I believe is in a very bad way. You see monuments and ruins all over our country, and they are all decaying.
Now things have changed. For example, if you now go to Mahabalipuram, we have taken a lot of improvement steps there. And we have in fact connected this Mahabalipuram shore temple with the Arjuna penance. And it has come out a beautiful green area around it. And all the slums are being relocated. And new areas are coming.
Right.
And it gives a very good impression about our conservation drive, our restoration drive. Not only in and Hampi also, we have sanctioned 8 crores of rupees in Mahabalipuram. 5 crores in Hampi.
But what is 8 crore for a site like that? You know, if Hampi was a site in a European country, you know, hundreds of millions of dollars would have gone into it. You know, look at the way Pompeii has been restored.
I agree.
Have you been to Pompeii?
Yes, I have. My point is, this is a beginning. And this has also made a lot of impact on what improvement have taken place.
Right.
So therefore, there is we have to go along with. There is no doubt about it. But even these improvements which we have made.
But you agree if Hampi was a place in Italy, they would have made not just a huge money spinner, but would have made a place to which it was so much easier to reach.
Yes, I agree that if you go by the past trend, what you say might be true. But if we now take into account the new drive that we have launched, the new initiatives that we have taken, I'm sure we will be able to do a better job than the Italians might have done in Pompeii. Because when you see this area, you will see
it's always said that when it comes to heritage, do as the Romans do.
Yes.
Because they've done such a marvelous job of preserving every little wall that they have.
I agree that the Romans have done a wonderful job. But we will definitely be not lagging behind. And so far, the results that we have achieved, they're very encouraging. We have done a lot of improvement in Red Fort. And even the Prime Minister mentioned what has been done, restoration work, the green development. All these monuments stand out.
Yeah.
Of course, the heritage of Rome is different than that of
In what sense?
It is different in the sense that it is in a different setting.
Right.
Different type of people go there. But we have such a backlog.
Jagmohan, how much money do you have to do all this every year?
No, money in my view is only one of the factors.
But how much money do you have?
We have about 325 crores of rupees.
325 crores is about $70 million.
$70 million
is what Italy or Germany or one of these countries would spend on one church.
I agree. But we have to have competing demands in various other sectors, of power, other things. We have to take care of this. So the idea is to make the best use of the resources. For example, now, if we are a disciplined nation, we can certainly create better environment around our monuments. And people will get attracted towards them.